So I hope you like that sound. Welcome to another puzzle solving video. And as you can see and hear, I have a new and different type of puzzle. This is called the Sherlock. It is a wood or wooden puzzle. It's one of those logic types of puzzle. Not too much different than the rush hour type of game where you have a bunch of cards. See-through window to give you a little sneak peek, a preview of what's inside before you buy it. So, this is a solo one-player game. There are 52 brain-bending puzzles, 32 precision cut wood rods. Let's flip this over. And then on the back, how to crack the case. Choose a challenge card. Collect the rods shown on the front of the challenge card, and then fit the rods completely inside the cube in order to crack the case. So most likely this is one of those games, logic games, that start off with some probably easy puzzles to solve at level the first card and the second card, and then progressively get more difficult towards card number 52. Okay, so let's open this up. I have not played this yet, so this is, I did take a look at it inside, but I have not even looked at the cards. Sleeve is a perfect tight fit. Okay. So here we can see we have a wood box. Sherlock. All right, let's open this up. Open it and close it just to make some nice sounds. So let's take another listen to all the... sound. Okay. All right. So what do we have here? We have these little, all of these rods. Let's just take a look at them. Okay. See how they're cut? And then we have such a way that they will all fit in. So that's going to be the object here. Okay, so let's put this one back. Cube. end this if... Well, we'll see as I go through the cards here as far as whether or not it's a good game, but just based on the fact that it's all made out of wood, make for a good gift, at least for someone. Okay. Let's see which... Okay, here's a little instruction pamphlet. Alright, you know what? I gotta stop trying to make sounds with everything. Okay. It's different languages here. This looks like French or something. Okay, hopefully you can see right here. It says challenge levels. There's 7 challenging levels. Elementary, junior case cracker, intermediate inspector, sly sleuth, ace detective, mystery mastermind, and Sherlock. Start with the elementary level to give the old noggin a warm-up. I'm gonna need to do that for sure. And work your way up. Or if you think you've got what it takes, dive right into the most difficult cases with the Sherlock level. Maybe next video. I don't want to embarrass myself right off the bat here. Okay, flip it over and we see levels 6 and 7. These challenges present the craftiest cases. To solve them requires additional steps by maneuvering a rod within the cube to allow another rod to be inserted into the cube. Such a rod, called a slider rod, may be partially inserted, then a subsequent rod is inserted, followed by the slider rod being completely inserted. Also note that some slider rods may need to slide more than once or in more than one direction. Okay, that's already confusing and hurts my brain, so we are not going to start with levels 6 and 7. So here's the slider rod. Okay. Tells you how to differentiate the slider rod. Here's the card anatomy of the front. Level, difficulty, challenge, card number. 6 or 7 rods required for this challenge, okay? Okay, we have the card anatomy, the back provides the solution. The order in which the rods should be inserted. Okay, let's see. Objective, fire up your keen sense of observation and unlock your superior Sherlockian mind to crack the mysterious case of the wooden puzzle like a true detective. Okay. Choose a challenge card from the case book, selecting from one of the 7 challenge levels. Collect from the box your cube and the rods shown on the front of the challenge card. Use your keen eye to observe every nook and cranny of the rods, and your cunning mind to plot their placement within the cube and solve the mystery. Begin inserting the rods into the cube one at a time in an attempt to complete the cube. All the rods must lock together and fit completely inside the cube in order to crack the case. Okay, let's give it a try. Alright, let's see what card we have. Start with number 1. Number 1, and I'll put this up here. There will be no rod in hole G. Okay, I need to know which hole is G. Okay, so G, if I hold the box this way, G is up here. A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Okay, no rod in G. So we have 2 rods going in here and 4 that way. I need 2 rods, label number 1. Okay, got those. 2 number 4s. So already I can tell that this is probably going to go on top. Off camera, I wouldn't worry about taking my time and trying not to make any loud, you know, sounds that can be not relaxing. Okay, so these are interesting, these ones here. Well, let's see if we just inside there because of the shadow, but the ones that I placed in here are just above the middle, so I can't put a 5 in there. Is this cheating? same thing as before. Well, okay, so this is... I'm getting old. Well, I am old. I'm getting older. So these are the slider rods, I believe. But it doesn't really matter too much. Okay, so we need to figure out how these are going to be inserted. Let me take a look. Here, so we have two going this way and four going that way. Well, we put the slider rods in there. So we need to have four. So these are going to allow the rods to pass over. And then we'll need... this is going to be tricky. I'm probably going to be here the rest of the video just trying to solve this one. This is difficult when you're trying to make a relaxing video. Trying to be aware of all the sounds and the environment and the sounds of these objects, and then also try to use my brain to solve a logic puzzle. There's too many things going on, but I'm not complaining. Okay, we don't want this piece to go here because it will go above and below. It'll block anything from going in, so I'm pretty sure these go on the bottom. I'm pretty sure. I mean, I don't think, wait, would they wouldn't go sideways. There's no point. They would go this way. Side, okay, break on to the other side. And then that one through. You can, there we go, okay. Now this is the tricky part. We have to get these two. Up. Maybe these don't necessarily go there. Okay, so maybe these sliders go up here. This one through here. Yeah, that might actually be it. Let me try. It might not be it. I don't know. Let's try the number 5. this piece is cut in the middle makes me think that it'll need to go in the middle. So that goes in the middle there. Same thing with the 5 on this side, but I think we put it this way. Wait, yeah, we should put it this way. Okay, we don't put the, maybe we don't put the slider in yet. Solid one in yet. Let's put the 5 in. But we'll put the 5 in with this part over here opposite that one. See what kind of patience you have. There you go. This is it. Blocking a little bit there, so I can't slide anything over it. solution is to put these pores in first. Thank you. taste be on top or the bottom? So that could work. Oh. Like that. That'll be the side. This piece could be the top. Like this. This would work, but then we have this solid one. Are you allowed to try to solve the puzzle this way? Okay, there's gotta be a way. If we do, if this is on the bottom, right, if we do it this way, has to be in the middle. It's definitely going. These pieces are definitely going somewhere. I think here. Yeah, not here or here. You wouldn't put these here because nothing's going to pass underneath here. And nothing's going to pass over top. So these definitely have to go in the middle. Over and under, but then the blocks over here, which means that we are going to need this. Try these again. So if I put this one here, and then this one on top, okay, that's not going to allow anything to pass over it here, which is my problem. I need something to pass over there, so if we do it, this one down there. No, this one has to go in the middle. This has to go in the middle. These both have to go here. Okay, so we know that. Let's do this again. Anything through these. I think these have to go last. always have to go last because they'll be sitting above, preventing anything. I mean, I don't think they put those in the middle. I don't want to look at the answer. Solution. Right. So the first. So number four. A, B, C, D. So the first step is putting number four in B. Here. And then the other number so I have it. So here's B and D, right? It doesn't really matter. We can just flip it over like this. There we go. Number one is... Okay. So the two fours are B and D. The two ones are A and C. And then E and F. Or five. R and E and F, the sides, E and F. So, there we go. That took me, it shouldn't have taken me that long. I did honestly think of putting the two fours on top of each other like that. This is really good. I love it. Definitely challenging. I love a good challenge. Let me just take a break here just for a moment. Okay, yeah, this video is already long enough. I did spend about 15-20 minutes with introduction. So, next time there'll be less introduction, of course, and more puzzle solving. But I will open the case and I'll make all those sounds with all the pieces in the case, and then we'll put everything away like this. So I hope you enjoyed, I hope you found this to be relaxing. And we will put that in the back of the stack. And hopefully next video we will do number 2. Hopefully 3, 4, and 5. See if we can do a few more of them. Okay. Alright, so let me put all these back. Put number 1. Another number 1. Let's see, number 5. Like an ASMR kit or box, like I said earlier. Okay, thank you very much for watching, and stay tuned for I will try to do these once a month or every other month. So that only one piece remains in the center. So I'll be doing that one. The next.